I've seen this over and over again in many companies. Someone sends an Excel file in an email, a very important report that management is already waiting for. The person receiving the email opens the file, they hit print to get the paper copy of the report to the manager, and then this happens. The wrong bits come out in the wrong places. Now, I can't tell you how often I've seen managers sitting in meetings frustrated with their printed reports when they only had column headings on the first page, missing page numbers, so they can't even tell if something is missing, or even a report where important parts of the spreadsheet never made it to the printer. Now, I think we both agree, it's quite frustrating, but the great news is it can easily be avoided. Plus, we don't waste valuable resources. Let me show you how you can optimize your Excel sheets for printing. This video is brought to you by Excel Essentials for the Real World. Learn Excel from scratch or fill in the gaps to become immediately confident. Discover hidden tips and tricks which get you working smarter, not harder. Click on the link below or type in xclplus.com/courses. Excel's default print settings generally don't work to your advantage. Default orientation is portrait, but your data sets might be wider than they're tall. It will make automatic page breaks based on paper size, scale options, and your margin settings. All of these settings you can change, and you probably should change before you hit that print button. Let's start off with some useful printing options. So let's say I have this report, I want to get it printed. First thing I'm going to do is to take a look at it in Print Preview. You can get there by going to your Quick Access toolbar and using Print Preview and Print. If you don't have this option here, click on this dropdown and add it by putting a check mark here. What it does when you click it, you go to the printing options. Another way to get here is to go to File, Print. Now immediately I notice this report is going to be printed on two pages. This is not what I want. I want it to fit on one page. I can make the adjustments either directly here in this view, or I can go to the worksheet and make the adjustments directly there. You pretty much have the same options. You just have to pick the way you feel most comfortable with. So I'll show you both. Here, let's say I wanted to reduce the margins to save up some space. I can switch this from normal to narrow. It's still fitting on two pages though. I can change the orientation directly from here and select landscape instead of portrait. Now, this is again not something I want. To make this fit on one page, I need to go to scaling here and I can select fit sheet on one page. Now, let me show you the options on the page layout side. And there's some useful ones there too. So let's go to page layout. This is where you're gonna find the printing options. These are what we saw in backstage view. Now, if you click on this tilted arrow here, you get two more options. Some of it is what you see here. Some of it are stuff that they couldn't fit here. So you have additional options available in here. For example, one option I personally use a lot is the margins, and that's how I want my report to be centered on the page, because by default the report is always centered to the top left hand side. Sometimes I want it to be centered horizontally and vertically so it sits in the middle of the paper. So these are the options that you need on their margins, horizontally, vertically, and I got to it by going to more options here. Now you can also get to this from backstage view, and I'll show you how in a second. But before we go back to backstage view, let's just check some more options here. By default, reports don't print grid lines. If you want grid lines to be printed, put a check mark for printing of grid lines. The other thing I like about this view is that I can immediately see the percentage that's associated with scale. Remember, when we fit this to one page, we basically made it shrink. You don't want it to shrink too much so that everyone can read it. Now, how can you influence this percentage and increase it further? So one way we did was to adjust the margins, but there's only so much you can do with margins. Another way is to reduce the space, so maybe hide any rows or columns that you don't need. So the more condensed your report gets, the higher this percentage is going to get. So this already jumped up to 80%. Now it's up to 82%. Okay, so let's just go and see how this report looks. I can get to print preview from here, but let me also show you another option. Remember, when we were in this view, we can also directly go to print preview or directly print from there. So now grid lines were activated. This is how the report is going to look, and it still fits on one page. Now remember how I centered this? I told you I'm going to show you how that works from backstage view. You can get there by going to custom scaling options, and you come to the same dialog box we saw before. This is the type of report we're dealing with. So in the first step, let's say we're just interested to print parts of this. We just want the list of apps and sales for 2019. One way to do this is to highlight the area you want printed and go to File, Print, change this dropdown to Print Selection. The moment you do that, it shows you what you've selected on the Excel side, and that's what it's going to print. It's one of one. So notice when I go back to Active Sheet, it's actually by default going to print this on four separate sheets. Now, what if you always wanted to just print those two columns whenever someone pressed print? You don't want them to remember to highlight and then go select Print Selection. You just want them to be able to press print, and it only prints those two columns. The way you can set this is to go to Page Layout, highlight the area that you want, and then set the print area by clicking on Print Area and then set it. This forces the print area to always only be this area. So now anytime we go to Print Preview, we only see what we selected. So notice this side is set to Print Active Sheets. It sees the active sheet as only these two columns. It completely ignores everything else. So that's the advantage of setting your print area. Let's remove this print area. Clear print area. Now let's say I want to print this full document, and I want to have my table in one page and the two charts on another page. How can I make Excel format this properly for me? Well, I have some options here from scale to fit. I could say try to fit this on one page, and the height should be probably two pages. I mean, I can try one page. Scale is really low, which means everything is going to be super small. If I go to print preview, I don't really want it like this. I want them sitting on their own pages. Now let's also change the orientation of this and see if that improves. That reduces the scale even further. How do I get Excel to actually fit the page breaks to where I want? This is where you can insert your own page breaks. What I'm going to do is just set this back to automatic. Let's go and insert a page break right here. Now let's go and take a look at how this is going to look until now. The scale is still set to 54%. We don't want that scaling, so let's change that. This part looks good, but this part doesn't look good. It's cutting through one of my charts. I want both charts to fit on one page. This is where you can directly control the page breaks. To do that, go to the View tab and click on Page Break Preview. This takes you out of normal view and shows you how Excel is planning to print. The dark blue borders are the ones that we've set, and the dashed ones are the ones that Excel set for us. Now this one I'm not so happy about, so I'm going to pull it that way because I want it to force the page break to be here so the full chart can fit in. And I can also reduce that column, and notice here behind there's another page break. That's where it was cutting my chart. Now I'm going to push that down as well to make this part fit on the second page. And I can even expand this further as well and then adjust my charts. Right, so it takes a little bit of adjustment to get it fit the way you want. Now let's go back to normal view. We can see the other page breaks have adjusted. Let's go to print preview and we can see everything fits well. So that's how you can use page breaks to get full control over your printouts. So these are my Excel printing tips for today. Who knows, your manager might be so impressed with your neat printouts, they might just give you that promotion. Now, this video is a part of my Excel Essentials for the Real World course. If you're interested to find out more, go to xclplus.com/courses. That's it for today. In case you're new here, don't forget to subscribe before you leave so that you can get updates when I put out new videos. And I'll see you in the next video.